Hi, welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing how you can make your own drone. So this model is going to be an F450 drone. The drone is sent in by a guy named Yashin Mehaboob. So thanks to him for sending it. Also, this is a complete remake. This is not the actual video. The actual video had many mistakes, so there might be some skip parts. Also, this is a full tutorial. If you don't want to watch me making a drone for an entire 5 minutes, you can just watch my short video on the iCards right here, or you can just click on the description. I'll give the link of that video. So if you have any question regarding the video, you can ask me in my Instagram page. I'll answer it as soon as possible at Hani's Experiments. Also, if this is your first time in my channel and want to see more of my experiments, start now by clicking that red subscribe button and that small bell icon so you get notified when I upload videos. So if you're planning on buying the drone kit that I'm going to be building, I'll give the link of the drone kit under the description of this video. Also, you can buy the parts separately. I'll give the link of that also. So let's get into the video. So this is the box and it's so big I can't do it like I usually do on a table. So let's open it. Solder these bullet connectors to the ESCs because these don't come with the bullet connector. Soldering these connectors are like really hard, so it took about 30 minutes just to complete all of these. Also, I'm going to be covering the exposed parts with electrical tape. So I have put the insulation tape. It's not the best, but it works. I soldered the battery connector. Now the next step is to solder all the 4 ESCs. You can see I have soldered all the ESCs and it's not the best, but I did my best. To attach the legs to the base, and the red legs are the front part of the drone. Make sure to pull the ESC wires out through these holes. I need to connect the speed controller wires. So before we tie our ESCs, make sure the motors are placed correctly, like shown in the diagram here. So this should be counterclockwise, this should be clockwise, this should be counterclockwise, and this should be spinning clockwise. Now we need to take our flight controller. So let's open it. This is the flight controller. See that? Now we need to stick our flight controller on the quadcopter. For that, we'll be using some double-sided tape. It says forward right there. So this is our front part of our quadcopter. Now we need to connect our ESC wires. For this, we need to connect it like shown in the diagram. So this will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. So make sure the white wire is facing forward. Now this is the front part of the flight controller. These are the inputs. So we need a jumper wire. We have 7 jumper wires. So this doesn't come with the drone. You need to buy it separately. So first 3 wires should be connected to 1, like that. Other 4 wires should be connected to the top parts of 2, 3, 4 and 5, like that. Now we need to connect our receiver that comes with our transmitter. Just like we did on here, connect the first 3 wires on the first part of the receiver. Now other 4 wires connected to channel 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now apply some double sided tape and stick it. I like to place it on the side. You can place it anywhere you like. So let's start off by installing the application for our setup. So it's called Mission Planner. You need to download this. I'll give it in the description below. You can download it under there. Now click connect on the top right corner. So that's done. Now go to setup, click mandatory hardware. The frame type is always cocker, make sure that's on. Now axial calibration, this is the first calibration. So click calibrate axle. Now place vehicle level and press any key so it's leveled on the left. Now on the right. Now nose down. Now nose up. Now place it on the back. Now the calibration is successful. Now the next step is to calibrate the internal compass. So click live calibration. Click OK. Now you'll see many dots. Make sure you can get as many as possible. Like move it around as much as possible until you hear a beep. So we heard a beep. After that we need to do the radio calibration. That's for your transmitter. Now turn it on. Radio calibration. So click on calibrate radio. Click OK. Now we'll see some red lines. So move the sticks in all direction as possible on the farthest positions. And you'll see the red slowly showing the end points of the signal. Now make sure you do this also. With this is the mode change, we haven't done that yet. So that's done. Now click when done. Now radio calibration is done. Now after the radio calibration, we need to do the flight modes on the transmitter. So we have set the switch, the channel 5 to switch C. You can adjust it on your transmitter. I'll give a small video on the description where you can change it, how you can change it. Now all of these are in stabilize. Now the first one is always should be in stabilize, and fourth mode for me I'll put in alt hold, and the sixth mode in land mode. Now save the modes and make sure it shows up on the current mode. So it's stabilize. Now alt hold. Now land. So this is backup. Now that's all. Now we need to attach the propellers and fly this. Now we need to attach the legs for the drone. I should have done this earlier but I forgot about it. So these are the legs. We need to remove these screws and attach the legs. This is screw that came up with the legs. I'm going to be using these because these are slightly longer than the original one. So we need to attach the legs like that. We need to insert the screw through the legs. Now we need to attach the battery strap. Now, so if you don't know how to attach propellers, I'll give a small video under the description that I made. Where you can check out how you can attach the propellers. So we have finally built our drone, and look at how big this thing is. Now all we need to do is to charge the battery, attach the battery and fly this beast.
One hour later.
So roll the montage. We'll be right back. video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any question regarding the video, you can ask me in my Instagram page. I'll reply to you as soon as possible at Hani's Experiments. So if you're planning on buying one of these, I'll give the kit under the description below. You can also buy the parts individually. I'll give the link of that also. So if you ever get a chance to make one of these, go for it, because it's really worth every penny. I wouldn't recommend for children under 14 because drones are kind of dangerous for them. So by the end of the video, I have broken a lot of stuff, including a speed control motor, a whole charger, and almost broke my action camera on the drone. So here's a quick. So if I have made any mistakes on the video, you guys can explain it to me in my Instagram, because this is my first time building it. So that's all. Click here to watch my last video and click here to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.